Your Eminence, what does John Henry Newman mean to you personally?
Well, today is just so full of joy, I'm short of words, and that doesn't often happen to me. But I think he's somebody who teaches us that faith lodges in our hearts, and in that heart, in dialogue with God, and in conversation and friendship and love with each other, that's the root of our faith and where we live it day by day.
So what does John Henry Newman mean for you?
John Henry Newman means a great inspiration for me in my faith. He was a man of tremendous courage, that's the way I see him. When he saw what God wanted him to do, he did it regardless of the cost. It was just terrific, and I found that really inspiring.
What does John Henry Newman mean for you, Father?
Of course, I've known Cardinal Newman when I was an Anglican for many years by singing his beautiful hymns. And so I've always had an interest in the Cardinal. And I read about him, I wrote a little book about him. I mean, the great thing, what he means to me, is that I followed with my small shoes in his giant footsteps into the church.
But I think that at this moment in time, we're just coming to the end of the diary tour of Our Lady of Walsingham. We're looking for the re-evangelization of England. To canonize him at this moment couldn't be more important. He was an early convert from the Anglican Church, came into the Catholic faith, and I just feel that England is ripe for conversion back to the faith, and raising him up to the altar at this point, his intercession for us couldn't be more important at this moment in time.
We thank God that we were able now to experience this wonderful celebration. And thank you for what you are doing at EWTN, because I heard that both who had been have got the miracle came to know Newman by EWTN. So we are very have to be very grateful to you as well.
We're very grateful to you. Thank you very much, Mother.
Thank you.
Thank you. God bless you. What does John Henry Newman mean for you?
Oh, everything. Importance of the laity, development of doctrine, and the importance of a right conscience.
Wonderful.
Just wonderful to be at the canonisation, to experience that, and to now continue to ask for his intercession.
John Henry Newman means an inspiration of holiness, an inspiration to always seek the truth in Jesus Christ.
I've always been impressed by his pastoral care of people.
I'm named for John Henry Newman. My father had a great devotion to him, and my son, who's here with me, is also named John Henry. The whole focus on the interior life, the great sensitivity of his soul spoke to me, and so we couldn't miss the opportunity to be here.
And he's been such a contribution to the church in theological terms, but also in terms of sanctity.
Well, for me, I feel John Henry is really all about the still small voice, and that's what's really inspired me about him and my journey, is really to listen closely to the quiet voice of the Lord.
We are called to love and to endure during the suffering, and also to always serve others and teach them about God and his great way of loving your neighbor, especially students right now in colleges that are lost in the universities, that they don't know much about God. That's why all the Newman Centers are there, for them to learn and have formation.
He realized in his studies of the early church that the true church of the apostles was not the Anglicans, but the Catholic Church of Rome. In those days in England, the Catholic Church of Rome was hated. Priests were murdered. He was perhaps the foremost celebrity of the Anglican Church, the most beloved clergyman in all of England. So what does he do when faced with the reality, the truth? He converts to Catholicism. His friends walked away from him. He was left all alone in this world. But he knew he was following the truth. He wrote a poem, "Lead Me On, Tiny Light of Truth. Amidst the encircling gloom, I ask not to see the distance seen. One step is enough for me."